Hello everyone. Narcissist Free Almost here, and today's topic is on the paranoid schizoid position, according to Melanie Klein's Objects Relations Theory. Here I'll describe normal infant development paranoid schizoid position, contrasting it with psychotic's paranoid schizoid position in development. While listening to this, keep in mind that the narcissist or borderline lies somewhere in between. But first, the paranoid schizoid position refers to a constellation of anxieties, defenses, and internal and external object relations that Klein considers to be characteristic of the earliest months of an infant life and continues to a greater or lesser extent into childhood and even adulthood. The chief characteristic is the splitting defense of both the self and object into good and bad, with at first little to no integration between. Recall the part objects I've been talking about, where there is a space between, seen here on the slide. Infants, according to Klein, suffer a great deal of anxiety caused by the death instinct thanatos, experienced at birth, and by experiences of hunger and frustration. She assumes the very young infant to have rudimentary unintegrated ego structure that attempts to deal with these experiences, particularly anxiety, by using fantasies of splitting, projection, and introjection. The infant splits both his ego and his object and projects out separately his loving and hating instincts into separate parts of the mother or breast, if you will. Important aspects here are omnipotence and idealization for projection, and bad experiences are omnipotently denied. Good experiences are exaggerated and idealized for fear of the persecuting breast, or mother. In other words, the infant, fearing retribution for hating the breast, in turn fears the breast, or that mother will retaliate in kind. So the mechanism of omnipotence and idealization are vital for the survival of the infant, in the infant's own mind. Binary splitting is immensely helpful here as well. It is essential for healthy development as it enables the infant to take in and hold on to sufficient good experience to provide a central core around which to begin to integrate the contrasting aspects of the self. The establishment of a good internal object is thought to be a prerequisite for the later working through the depressive position. And I'll talk about that in future videos. Now, a different kind of splitting fragmentation, in which the object and or self are split into many smaller pieces, is also a feature of the paranoid schizoid position. This would run along the lines of psychotic development, that I'll get to in a minute. Persistent and enduring use of fragmentation and dispersal of the self weakens the fragile, unintegrated ego and causes severe disturbance. Here are some constitutional factors to keep in mind for the healthy development of an infant. The balance of the life and death instincts. And the mothering that the infant receives, this is a central environmental factor. If development proceeds normally, extreme paranoid anxieties and schizoid defenses are largely given up during early infantile paranoid schizoid position, and during one working through the defensive position. However, schizoid ways of relating are really never given up completely and can be conceptualized as transient states of mind. The paranoid schizoid position can be thought of as the phase of development preceding the depressive position as a defense against it and also as a regression from it. Next, there is pathological development. The psychopathology of this earliest phase of development is the most obscure and difficult problem in psychoanalytic research. According to Klein, the fixation points of psychosis lie in the earliest months of infancy. Furthermore, in psychological illness, regression occurs, not to a phase of development that was in itself normal, but to one in which pathological disturbances were present, creating blocks to development and constituting fixation points. In other words, the psychotic child regresses to a phase in development which already possessed pathological features in infancy. In normal development, the paranoid schizoid is characterized by a split between good and bad objects and the loving and hating ego, split in which the good experiences far outweigh the bad. This is a necessary precondition for integration in the later stages of development. The infant organizes his perceptions by means of projection and introjection, just like I talked about in the last video. Disturbances occur when, for external, internal, and more often than not, both, the bad experiences predominate over the good. Under unfavorable conditions in the paranoid schizoid position, projective identification is used differently from the way it is used in normal development. In normal development, remember that the infant projects part of the self and objects into the breast object. These projected parts are relatively unaltered in the process of projection, and when subsequent reintrojection takes place, they can be reintegrated into the ego. When anxiety and hostile and envious impulses are intense, projective identification happens differently. The projected part is splintered and disintegrated into minute fragments that are projected into the object, disintegrating it into minute parts. The aim of this violent projective identification is twofold. In pathological development, the experience of reality is felt primarily as persecution. There is a violent hatred of all experience of reality, external and internal. The splintering of the ego is an attempt to get rid of all perception and its perceptual apparatus that is primarily attacked, destroyed and obliterated. At the same time, the object which is responsible for the perception, is hated and the projection is aimed at destroying that object, as well as getting rid of the perceptual apparatus which perceived it, namely the ego. In summary, I talked about the paranoid schizoid position both in normal and pathological development. A normal, healthy infant will use the processes of projection and introjection, along with good experiences to help build their ego, self, and other objects into an integrated whole. The pathological infant begins with a fractured ego and fails to alleviate intense hatred, envy, and frustration, thus perceiving the external objects as bad and withholding. In turn, external objects are too painful to perceive, and the infant's mind sets out to destroy the perceptual apparatus that causes it so much pain, that being the ego. And this would be the case in schizophrenia and psychosis. Somewhere, in the middle you have your narcissist or borderline. I know in my case, Narc 2 sees the world in an immature black and white, and even other adults in part objects, good or bad. I have witnessed, firsthand, micro-episodes of what might appear as psychosis. There's the magical thinking, projective identification, and the paranoia of persecution, which often takes the form of stalking, and or fully destroying and sabotaging his targets. So you can see, there was either a culmination of bad experiences disrupting his normal development, which I find very little evidence of, or he was pathological to begin with. And I'm thinking the latter is the case, in my situation. How about you? Where do you find your narcissist? Was their normal, healthy development disrupted by some sort of trauma? Or do you think they started out with pathological development to begin with? Something to think about. Well, that's it for today. Please remember to like, comment and subscribe, as well as join me on Facebook at Narcissist Free Almost, and Instagram at Clumber_Lover with a U. I do hope that helped someone today, and as always, love to all, and I hope you're all enjoying peace of mind living narcissist free. I know. I am.